Je ne peux penser qu'à toi. Je ne peux penser qu'à toi.
So today we're talking tattoos. I have three of them, and the baby ones. They're all baby ones, but I thought I'd share with you. I thought I'd share with you the stories behind them because I love tattoos. I think they're beautiful. So my first tattoo I ever got is right here, and I'm sure probably a lot of you have seen this one. You've seen Dr. Wu on Instagram or on BuzzFeed. This is definitely something that's inspired by his designs. So what I actually did was I took three of his arrow designs and I took it to the tattoo shop and I incorporated something from each arrow design and I made my own. And I got it at Silver Lake Tattoo in LA, and it was done by a very, very old Chinese man. He's like been doing it for 50 plus years, I think, and all the locals really love him. This is probably my most affordable tattoo out of everything. It was $50 and then I tipped him. So the design itself is just an arrow, and that just symbolizes direction and the path you take in life. But specifically, each piece in my design means something. So I have two circles because one circles are my favorite shape, and two, it's just supposed to symbolize how life is kind of cyclical. You know, once you're born, you die, and then another person is born, and then they die. So it's kind of just to put into perspective how, in the end, nothing really matters, and like my daily stresses are not such a big deal, so I should just calm down. And then I specifically got two lines for the body of the arrow because I wanted that to symbolize that there's, you know, more than one path in life, and you can take any which one you want. So there's no one straight and narrow path. And then there's actually two little carrots or arrows that are pointing in the same direction, and that's just like symbolizing my parents because, you know, they like raised me, nurtured me, and they provided me with all the resources, and they kind of just gave me a direction to go on, and so that's why there's two of them. And then it's shooting back into life, which is, you know, how I told you, you know, both those lines are shooting back into a circle, which is life, so there's more than one direction in life. So cheesy. And then of course the last arrowhead, the main one, that's supposed to symbolize me, because even though my parents and life, everything happens, like in the end, ultimately, I'm the captain of where I want to go and where I want to take this life. So yeah, that's basically what my first tattoo means. It's very cheesy, but I really like it. This is probably my most favorite tattoo of the three, especially because it's my first one, and it just means a lot. So my second tattoo is right here on my wrist, my right wrist. And originally I wanted to get a tattoo that was here, but I've heard it's a very painful place, and that's because that's where you get your IV and there's a lot of veins. So I kind of chickened out last minute, and I was like, you know what, the side is just as cool. So I got it here, and it says in Korean, Hinne, and I am 100% Korean. I was born here in the States. For those of you who don't really know, I'm very proud of my culture, and just as a person myself, I really, really treasure and love culture, and I feel like everyone should kind of hone their culture, whatever that is, because that is what makes everyone unique. Just learning about, you know, different traditions and different foods and different lifestyles, which I think is one of the most enriching things we can all learn. I feel like if we all learned about each other's cultures, we would have a lot more empathy. I got this one in London at a pretty famous tattoo shop. It's called The Circle London, and this was recommended to me by a friend who actually got her sleeve done there. The reason why I don't like this tattoo is because, I'm gonna be honest with you, I hated my experience there. It's a very big tattoo shop where, in the sense, if you don't want to get your tattoo there, they don't care. They don't want your business because they always have business. And I feel like I got this last year, so when I was around 20, turning 21, and I feel like I was very impressionable at the time, so I was scared to leave the shop when he said he wouldn't do what I wanted, and so I ended up just kind of relenting and doing whatever he said. So I wouldn't recommend that tattoo shop just because they're very specific on what type of tattoos they do, but I don't know. Anyways, it's up to you. It was a great tattoo shop, but I just didn't like my tattoo artist, and I didn't like my experience because he was very, very pushy, and he just kept giving me ultimatums, like it's this way or no way at all, and I really didn't like that. I felt very uncomfortable, and I should have just walked out with my deposit and just left, but anyways, so Himne just basically means kind of like, if you know, fighting or fighting, it's just like something you say to someone when they're feeling down. It just means like cheer up, stay strong. I think literally it means to exert your strength. The meaning of this tattoo was I was going through a really rough time last year in London when I was studying abroad, and this was just one of probably the best moments in my life up till now, because studying abroad was one of my dreams, but my mom said she financially couldn't support me doing that, and I just randomly happened to land a deal with Macy's, and with that money I paid for my own tuition, my housing, my plane tickets, shopping, and I just still felt, I woke up every day having bad dreams, anxiety, and it was just hard for me because I was like having such a great time and doing such an amazing thing for myself, but I just couldn't enjoy myself at the time. And so I kind of wanted to get this tattoo kind of just to remind me, you know, stay strong. Cheer up, you know, like get through it because this is such an awesome time. So originally that's what that meant, but then also it's just an homage to my Korean culture because I never want to forget that. And like I told you guys, I love culture, like whatever culture you come from, like I really really hope that you don't erase that part of you, because you know, eventually we're all gonna be just kind of like a mestizo breed. That sounds so bad, but basically we're all gonna be just like a mixed species, and I feel like culture is just gonna kind of go everywhere. And so I feel like we really gotta hold on to some of the culture because of the traditions and the storytelling and all of that I'm just very into. And so I even took classes at UCLA on what it's like to be Korean American, or what it means to be Korean American. I took a history class on like the building of Koreatown in LA, and I took a class on Korean history, and I just learned so much about my culture and Korea, South Korea, just actually Korea as a whole. Even in the ancient times, when there's the three kingdoms, they were all fighting for their own territory and lands, and it was one dynasty that kind of finally brought everybody together. So even in the ancient times, Korea was always kind of just like at war, trying to find its own place in the world, I guess. Learning about South Korea in the 80s with the democratization movement and the Gwangju massacre, all of that just, you know, there was so much political corruption and so much uprising that it really really hurt my soul. And I think to this day, even with the division of South and North Korea, I think it's due to a lot of political external forces. And you know, Korean people have been through so much, both North and South Korea, and you know, this is just kind of like to symbolize that, you know, Himne, like stay strong Koreans, because you know, you guys, have been through so much. The reason why it kind of looks like this weird geometric linear font is because it is literally the Hangul keyboard. It is literally the Korean keyboard on iPhone, and we just printed it out and blew it up. But he was a white British guy and he really had no idea what he was doing. And I kind of like, I mean, the point of this was to kind of match my geometric linear design over here, because as you will notice, that is pretty much my style. I really love geometric linear designs, like shapes and stuff. So I really wanted not a calligraphy font. I wanted something to look very geometric and just full of shapes, basically. And then my last tattoo is on the back of my neck, and this one is, I got this one again last year. And growing up, I read a lot of fashion blogs and I loved like Vogue magazine, and I remember seeing all my favorite fashion bloggers going to Fashion Week, and you know, they were getting paid to go there. I told myself it was like my childhood dream to be able to get like flown to New York, just go to New York Fashion Week and be in the scene of it all. And it happened. So to kind of commemorate that, I got Vagabond, which is VGB, on my neck. I tried to get in a place where no one could really see it because it seems really really narcissistic to have your blog name on your back, but I just really really wanted to commemorate this time in my life. Like, I never want to forget what I accomplished at 21, just because it was a really sentimental moment for me. I never ever thought that, you know, my YouTube would take me that far, and I never want to forget that. Like, when I'm a grandma, I want to always remember that. I got this at a pretty well-known tattoo shop. I think it's called Westport Tattoo in New York. It was pretty expensive, it was $80. I tried to get another font that was very geometric centered. That's why it has all these little ends at the V, but I also really wanted it to be thin, like most of my tattoos. It took about 5 minutes, didn't hurt at all. It was very, very actually therapeutic because it's on the back of your neck. That was it. I probably won't be getting any more tattoos, but we'll see. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye. Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Amy from Vagabond Youth. Today I am showing you guys 8 different outfits on how to transition your summer pieces into fall, because Lord knows you don't need to be shopping every new season. That would be so much money.